Hey guys, Derek and
Paula here
from Back to Reality. So last week we showed you how we've been working to expand our garlic bed. But as some of you may recall, we also decided to do the same thing with our potatoes. So today we're going to show you how we did that and then do our final harvest to see how it all turned out. Now last year we grew our first ever potato crop in one of our Ruth Stout beds. And honestly, it was incredibly rewarding because it was super easy and resulted in a pile of food. All we did was lay out some spoiled hay on top of the grass the previous autumn, and then in the spring, we pulled the hay apart, tossed in the spuds, and covered them back up until it was time to harvest. That was it. No digging, tilling, watering, or weeding. We did add a bit of extra mulch on top as the plants grew to keep the sun off the tubers, but when compared to the usual method of hilling with earth, we can confidently say that these potatoes were no work at all. If you haven't seen our previous videos on this method, we highly recommend you check those out first, so I've put some links in the description. But suffice it to say, our only regret is that we didn't plant way more of them. Paul and I tend to eat a lot of potatoes throughout the year, so if we ever hope to become fully food self-sufficient, one row just isn't gonna cut it. When we first started building our fence a few years ago, we figured 50 feet by 50 feet would be more than enough space. But as our crops increased, it quickly became apparent that we would eventually outgrow our confines. But a fence only protects against larger animals, like rabbits, raccoons, and deer. So unless a particular veggie is part of their diet, keeping them inside the fence would be of little benefit. That's why we decided to plant our garlic outside the fence, and when it was time to expand our potato crop, it was an easy decision as well. You see, for the most part, garlic and potatoes only suffer from small pests like insects and nematodes. And while these can pose a pretty serious problem for your plants, they can also pass through any normal fencing material anyway. So outside the fence makes good sense. For the initial move, we started with a new, much larger 20-foot by 40-foot Ruth Stout bed, but we have plenty of space to expand even further into the field if needed. We've covered the Ruth Stout method pretty extensively already, so I won't bother going into much detail now, but essentially we mowed the area last fall and covered it with a thick layer of old hay. Then in the spring, we decided to create walking paths by removing some of the mulch. Our intention was to mimic the shape of a keyhole garden to a certain extent, in order to minimize the amount of paths while also maximizing the amount of easily accessible growing space. This also had the side benefit of subdividing our plot into 7 sections so that we could easily separate the different varieties when planting. Plus, it also gave us an early opportunity to observe the Ruth Stout method in action. Because it had only been one winter, and yet much of the old grass had already decomposed, and no new weeds had begun to grow. Simply looking to the lush grasses outside the garden immediately highlights the difference you can make with just a layer of hay. Next came the actual planting, but once again, it was a simple matter of lifting the hay, tossing in the spuds, and then dropping the hay back down. Our varieties included one row of early season Norland, 3 rows of russet, a row of Pontiac, another of early season Warba, and finally in the last row, we planted a mix of leftovers that we had saved from last year's crop. These had simply been kept in a cardboard box throughout the winter, and as you can see, they'd grown some pretty impressive stolons. All in all, we planted about 34 pounds of seed potatoes, and it took us less than half an hour. We even had quite a bit of space left over, so we decided to throw in a row of onion sets as well. And then as usual, all that was left was to wait. But after several weeks, the leaves began breaking through the mulch. Next came some flowers, and eventually by around mid-summer, we began weekly and then almost daily meal-sized mini harvests. This continued until a couple weeks ago when the foliage had fully died off on the 2 rows of early varieties, so we decided to harvest them completely. And much to our delight, we gathered a combined total of 65 pounds. And now it's finally time for our full harvest. Just like last year, harvesting potatoes from a Ruth Stout garden is a simple matter of pulling aside the hay to expose the tubers and then collecting them. No tools are required, there's no risk of cutting or damaging the potatoes in any way, and the soil never has to be disturbed. But speaking of the soil, keep in mind that 1 year ago this was all thick grasses, weeds, and wildflowers, and yet now it's fully exposed earth with plenty of compost material mixed in. Plus, I know I mention this a lot, but honestly, just look at all the earthworms. They're everywhere. And they're not the only critters who seem to enjoy this natural habitat either. For example, we came across toads, blue-spotted salamanders, and even a northern red-bellied snake. But don't worry, this little guy is completely harmless to humans and spends most of his time eating grubs, slugs, and snails. So he's pretty bad news for our slimy friends, but he's also an excellent form of natural pest control and an important part of our healthy ecosystem. Now, I have to say we really enjoy the process of harvesting potatoes in this way. It's easy, it's relaxing, and honestly, it's also a lot of fun, uncovering so much food and interacting with so much nature. Once everything was harvested, we collected them all and weighed them. So now let's look at the numbers. As I mentioned, we initially planted approximately 34 pounds of seed potatoes, and our first harvest of the earlier varieties yielded 65 pounds. Then there's our weekly and daily harvests of young potatoes throughout the growing season, which we conservatively estimate to be around 30 pounds, especially considering that they would have weighed even more if they'd been left to mature fully. And finally, today's harvest weighed in at a whopping 242 pounds, which gives us a grand total of 337, or about 10 times our initial input. Now, I know this may not break any records or anything, but considering how little effort we had to put into this, I'm still pretty damn impressed. Oh, and really quickly, our onions turned out too. If you remember our first attempt in a new Ruth Stout bed last year, most were about golf ball size. But this year, we averaged around tennis ball. So they're still a bit small, but I'm pretty happy with that. However, it wouldn't be much of a learning experience if it didn't include a few lessons. So let's chat really quickly about some of the things we might do differently next year. First of all, the paths. In hindsight, it would have been far better to actually just leave the mulch in place and simply not plant where we plan to walk. Because after the potato plants begin to grow, the lack of vegetation between the rows would have clearly indicated the walking paths anyway. And unfortunately, without much mulch, the area quickly filled back in with weeds. Also, though we had originally planned on cutting our seed potatoes into sections before planting, unfortunately time constraints just simply didn't allow it. So we don't yet know which way is best, but we hope to try again next year. Plus, as you can see, a few of the tubers ended up all knobby and deformed. And from what I've read, that tends to happen as a result of inconsistent watering. Which actually makes a lot of sense because we didn't water them ever. We simply left that up to rainfall and the moisture retention of the mulch. Plus, this year we had a record-breaking drought for a couple months, followed by some pretty intense rainstorms later in the summer. But despite how funny they look, this shouldn't affect their flavor or nutrition, so we're not that concerned about it. However, we may still consider some form of irrigation in the future, just as a backup plan. And finally, though 337 pounds is a pretty incredible harvest, it's still likely not enough to keep us fed all winter, while also leaving enough for replanting in the spring. So I think we'll probably consider expanding our growing area even more than we did this time around. But for now, we're gonna have to figure out how the heck to store all of these.
See you guys soon.